إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، one of the most important things in your life as a believer, after declaring that La ilaha illallah, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, to say the second part, which is ashadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. And when you declare that Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, this means that you are believing that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger, and all the instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers came through Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this clear to us in many places in the Quran. So we see in Surah Al-Imran, قوله تعالى قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. Say, if you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then follow me, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you and forgive you your sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the oft forgiving, the most merciful. This is the way to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And particularly, when you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will be where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the believers. Jannatul Firdaus, Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah wa na'udhu bika min an-nar. And look here, brothers and sisters, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala linked the love of Allah with the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Actually, if you are asking how can I gain the love of Allah, then this is the way. Then follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَاتَّبِعُونِي. And when you follow Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, what you will gain? You will gain two things. The first thing, you will gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, you will gain the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the scholars, they said, when you look at the Quran, you'll find only Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who will have this promise. What's the promise? يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. He will forgive you all your sins. While with the other prophets, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ. He will forgive you some of your sins. But as a unique, as a privileged son, thing for Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in many places, يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. He will forgive you all your sins. How can I be entitled to the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? By following Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And mahabbatin Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is fard, is obligation. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he said that wallahi la yu'min حتى يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. You cannot be a true believer until the love of Allah and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is more beloved to you more than anything else. عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, and he's a great صحابي. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم hold his hand, and عمر found it a great opportunity to express the love to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he said, by nature, O Prophet of Allah, you are more beloved to me than anything except myself. This is the nature that as a human being, you like yourself, you love yourself. At that minute, the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't let it go without explanation. And he said to him, no, until I am more beloved to you than anything else. At that minute, Umar radiallahu ta'ala recognized that the natural thing is okay, but when you would like to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you have to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anything else. And he said, after he recognized that without the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he might be from among the people of Ahlul Nar, the people of Hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Umar to be a believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided Umar through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam must be the most beloved. And he said to him, Wallahi ya Rasulullah, innaka la ahabbu ilayya min nafsi. O Prophet of Allah, I love you more than I love yourself, myself. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Al-ana ya Umar. Now, Umar, what you are saying, you reach the highest level of Iman. This is the fard that on every Muslim to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than you love everything else. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said another hadith, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين. You will not be a true believer until you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than your father, more than your children, more than all the other people in the world. Subhanallah al-Azim. This is how we can say, yes, we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when you would like to put the love in grades, then on the top of the priorities will be the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And this love, how can I express it? Firstly, by following the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I cannot claim that I love the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam if I am following all types of innovation. I cannot claim that I love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when I find it difficult to follow even one of the sunan of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. I cannot claim that I love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when I am not trying to make my salah, the salah that I'm praying at least 5 times a day, is according to Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he's the one who said, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray as you have seen me praying. Then if I leave all the ahadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which describe his salah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then I follow just opinions, and this is what this imam said and this scholar said and my parents told me. I ignore all the ahadith about the salah and just follow certain opinions, then I cannot claim, or my claim will be invalid. I cannot claim that I love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and then after that I don't love his sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, because these sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, they are the people who followed the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sacrificed everything in their life for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you'll find them saying day and night, bi'abi anta wa ummi ya Rasulullah, I am ready to sacrifice my father and mother for you, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them in the Holy Quran, Then when someone comes and say we love Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, we love Al Bayt النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, then he curses Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Aisha, رضوان الله تعالى. How can you be a true Muslim if you are cursing the Sahaba of the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, if you curse the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. اتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, محبة النبي, following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the love of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, means that I have to find or try to find all types of sunan of the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام and apply it in my life. Look at Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما. He is narrating a hadith of the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, and while he's narrating the hadith, he laughed, he smiled, and they said to him, why you smile? He said, because when the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام narrated this hadith, he smiled. Allahu Akbar. Is there more than ittiba', following, more than this? He was walking in a trip, and there was a tree. So he went under that tree and sat down. They said, why you chose this tree? He said, because we were with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and we sat down with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم under this tree. So this is to show you how this only one example of Sahaba al-Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, how they followed the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام, and they understood the mahabba, the love of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, means that they are following every step that the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم did. A man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, O Prophet of Allah, متى الساعة? When will be the day of judgment? And Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم answered him in a very nice way, very kind way. He said to him, what did you prepare for? ماذا أعددت له? The man said, I didn't prepare for it a lot of salah or sawm or charity, but I love Allah and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. What the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, أنت مع من أحببت. You are with the one you love. الله أكبر. This is how the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us how we can be with the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثوبان مولى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم used to be with him, serving him. And one day he was helping the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in his wudu. And he said to him, Thawban, ask me. And Thawban, he said, O Prophet of Allah, أسألك مرافقتك في الجنة. Allah. Look, he didn't ask him for money, for position, for anything in this dunya. The only thing he asked, to be with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in Jannah. Then the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him the confirmation, yes, you'll be, but I need you to do something. He said, فَاعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكَ بِكَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ. If you'd like to apply this and you'll be with me in Jannah, then make a lot of sujood, means make a lot of nawafil, sunan salah. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us, brothers and sisters, in the Holy Quran, one of the ways to show our love to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said in Surah Al-Ahzab, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Allah and His angels, they are sending blessings on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. All you who believe, make salah and taslim on the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. So this is one of the ways that to show our love to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, especially on the day of Jumu'ah. And he said, the one who will make 10 salawat in the morning and 10 salawat in the evening on Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, then he will be entitled to the intercession of Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم on the day of judgment. The Sahaba رضوان الله تعالى عليهم, again brothers and sisters, showed us how much love they have for the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Look at this woman. from the Ansar. After the battle of Uhud, they told her that four of her family have been killed. Her father, her husband, her son, and her brother. So when they told her all these killed in the battle of Uhud, they are shuhada. Then what she said? She didn't start to cry or something. He said, no, I'd like to know what happened to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Tell me what happened to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And they said to him, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is there. He's there, he's alive. Then she went and she held to the tomb of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she said, بأبي أنت وأمي يا رسول الله لا أبالي إذا سلمت من عطب. I sacrifice my father and mother for you, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as long as you are safe sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Imam Malik rahimahullahu ta'ala, when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be mentioned, the name of him, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be mentioned, you'll find he will shaking, his color will change, and even the people who are listening to him, they find it very difficult to deal with Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala when he was in the situation while he's talking about Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even they narrated from Imam Malik, every time he'd like to narrate the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will go wear the best clothes that he had, and he would wear the best umama he has, and comb his hair, comb his beard, put perfume. Say to him, why you are doing this? He said, do you find this strange? I am talking, or I am saying hadith in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I must respect the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, even in the way that I am dressing and there. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه اجمعين. اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، افضل الصلاه واتم التسليم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه اجمعين. In the life of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, we'll find there are many things showed the love to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In authentic hadith, one of the camels came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and was making noise. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, this camel is complaining about how the owner of this camel treating him. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to give the khutbah next to a tree. Then one of the ladies, she said, O Prophet of Allah, shall we make a minbar for you? He said, if you'd like. So the next Jumu'ah, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam starting to deliver khutbat al-Jumu'ah from that minbar. And that tree, which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to deliver his khutbah from it, started to cry and making a noise. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went down and he hugged that tree until it calmed down. And Al-Hasan, when they used to mention this hadith, he said, Ya Ibadallah, Al-Khashabatu tahinnu ila Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shawqan ilayhi limakanihi min Allah fa antum ahaq an tashtaqu ila liqa'i. He said, O servant of Allah, the tree show compassion to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The tree loves the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You must love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than the tree. And this is what we try to do, brothers and sisters, all the time. What we must try to do. Mahabbat al-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam means that we follow him in all his instructions. When there is a hadith that the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is first hadith, we leave all the aqwal, all what the people saying, and follow hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We must all the time wish to meet the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Obviously we cannot meet him in person, but there are many people, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, they can see him in the dreams, and this is a sign of hubb al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And While we are talking about the love of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, we must also express our love to those people who are living where the grandfather of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم buried. Gaza, Palestine, this place where all Muslims' eyes are crying because what we are seeing, all the hearts feeling bad because what we are seeing in Gaza and the crimes that committed against our brothers and sisters there, the killing which is on daily basis, destroying the mosque, destroying the houses, throwing bombs which is never used in the last 50 years against any other country, but they are using it against the people who are in tents. And the people, their crime only that they are in that part of the world and they refuse to follow the instructions of the Israelis. This is why we must support these brothers and sisters as much as we can. I say this all the time. Keep praying, because the prayers, no doubt, it will give them the ability to steadfast and continue, inshallah, and support them with what we can of donation. And alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, our charity, we launched a week ago that we are feeding every day 400 families. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, will give them hot food. And we are planning to continue this at least for 1 month, inshallah ta'ala. For £40, you can support 10 families, inshallah ta'ala. So you can go to our website, Hayat Aid, and donate there, inshallah ta'ala. Allahumma inna nas'aluka fi yawmina hadha, an tansur al-islam wal-muslimin, wa an tu'izza kalimat al-haq wa-d-deen. اللهم عليك بالصهاينة ومن ولاهم، اللهم شتت جملهم شملهم وفرق جمعهم واجعل الدائرة تدور عليهم. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تنقذ أهلنا في فلسطين مما يكاد لهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل شهداءهم وارحم موتاهم واشف مرضاهم وداو جرحاهم وأطعم جائعهم واسق ظمآنهم وأنزل السكينة على قلوبهم. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعل لهذه الأمة رشدا وأن تنقذ هذه الأمة مما هي فيه من ضعف وهوان إلى عز الإسلام. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. وآخر السلام.